my name is Tejas and welcome to my channel Self Study with Tejas. Today we are going to learn NSO chapter 7, our environment. So let's start.
So first question, a sea breeze blows when the air above land is dash and the air above sea is dash. So a sea breeze blows when the air above land is warmer and the air above sea is colder. So this is the correct answer. Then second question, the process of water cycle that helps to fill well and sometimes lead to floods is also responsible for water loss from plant leaves. So B is the correct answer. Then third question, unscramble the given options and select the one that is not the cause for soil erosion. So this is plugging, this is afforestation, it is this is deforestation and this is overgrazing. So plugging, deforestation and overgrazing are responsible for soil erosion, and afforestation is not responsible for soil erosion. Means B is the correct answer. Then fourth question, select the option that arranges the major gases in air in decreasing order of their percentage. So first is nitrogen, then oxygen and then carbon dioxide. So means B is the correct answer. So fifth question, the given activity shows that dash. So the given activity shows that air is needed for burning. So C is the correct answer. Then sixth question, select the incorrect statement from the following. So A, the dark colored humus found in topmost layer of soil makes the soil fertile. Yes. Then B, afforestation protects the soil from erosion. Yes. Then C, chemical fertilizers are less harmful than organic manures. So that is incorrect because chemical fertilizers are more harmful than the organic manures. So C is the correct answer. Then seventh question, dash leads to the pollution of water. So A, throwing untreated industrial waste in water bodies. Yes, that leads to the pollution of water. So A is the correct answer. So eighth question, examine the experiment as shown in the given figure. 500 ml of water in flask X is heated until it is completely evaporated. The amount of water collected in flask Y will be about dash. So here the water is evaporating and when it is going in flask Y, here the condensation is happening. Means all the water will go there. Means it will be about 500 ml. So D, 500 ml is the correct answer. Then ninth question, match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct option. So here are causes of soil erosion and here are methods of soil conversion. So A, running water carries the topsoil with it. So methods for soil conversion for this are embankments and terrace farming. So 1 and 4. Then B, strong winds blow away humus rich topsoil. So this is because, so method is wind breaks and B2. Then C, indiscriminate cutting of trees. So it is 3, afforestation. So means D is the correct answer. So 10th question, which of the following is the best method of purification of muddy water? So best method of purification for muddy water is filtering through filter paper. Means C is the correct answer. Then 11th question, Charu continued to heat 100 ml of pure water for 5 minutes. So till it reaches its boiling point. Which of the following figures shows the result at the end of our experiment? So the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So option must be from A or B. So after constant boiling, the water changes into water vapor. Volume of water is decreases. So B is the correct answer. Then 12th question. Whenever we use the air conditioner, refrigerator, etc., we send P gases into the air. Which of these is P gas? So it is chlorofluorocarbon, that is BCFCs. So B is the correct answer. So 13th question, which of the following will help to reduce air pollution? So A, using CNG transport rather than petrol diesel transport. Yes, that's true. Then B, getting vehicle checked for pollution. Yes, that's also true. Then C, using public transport instead of private vehicles. So that is also true. Means D, all of these is the correct answer. So 14th question, a scientist observed a sudden increase in the number of algae in a lake over a few days. The reason behind it could be that dash. So A, water cycle in the area got imbalanced. No. Then B, electronic waste were being dumped in a nearby area. No. Then C, a factory with heavy smoke discharge has been established nearby. No. Then D, heavy amount of chemical fertilizers were being used in a nearby field. Yes, it can be there because chemical fertilizers are rich in nitrogen and phosphorus. Nitrogen content of water body favors algae growth. So D is the correct answer. Then 15th question, the change in the number of water plants in four ponds L, M, N and O over 4 months is shown in the graph. Which pond is the most polluted? So here polluted water affects the growth of the water plant. So from the graph, number of plants growing in pond is less. So in this graph, pond O water plants are less. So it is the most populated, so polluted, so it is the correct answer. So 16th question, achiever section. A factory was set up in an area which used to discharge its untreated waste down the pipe into nearby water body. After few years, the factory was shut due to some legal action. The given graph shows the changes in the populations of two organisms X and Y over time before the setting of factory and it was shut down. Identify X and Y and select the correct option. So here A, X could be bacteria and Y could be fish. So that is true because when the factory was set up, the population of X was increasing, and when the factory was set up, the population of Y was decreasing, and when the factory shut down, the population of X decreases and the population of Y is increasing. Means A is the correct answer. Then 17th question, which one of the following setup does not show that air occupies space? So in the D option, it does not show that air occupies space. Means D is the correct answer. So direction, question number 18, 19 and 20. Refer to the given paragraph and table and answer the following questions. So Priya took 100 gram each of three types of soil X, Y and Z in three separate pots with hole at the bottom. The amount of water that was poured over the pot containing the soil just before it started dripping from the bottom hole, it is tabulated here. So X 15 ml, Y 25 ml and Z 50 ml. So 18th question, the soil most suitable for pottery is clay soil, and clay soil holds a lot of water, and here Z is holding a lot of water, means Z is a clay soil, means C is the correct answer. Then 19th question, the soil suitable for growing watermelons and cactus is the soil X because it holds the least amount of water. A is the correct answer. Then 20th question, the soil that is a mixture of clay, sand and humus and is usually very good for growth of most plant is Y because it is holding a good amount of water for all the plants. Means B is the correct answer.
So friends, अगर आपको हमारा वीडियो पसंद आया हो तो लाइक, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब जरूर करना. थैंक यू.